Shard12 here, and today we're back with a new video. I've been gone for a long time, and it's mostly school, just having to worry about grades and everything, but I'm back. I don't know how, like, a schedule's gonna be with these videos, but I'm gonna try and make quite a bit more videos, and today we're playing a game called Blade and Soul. The game came out about 3 weeks ago, I want to say, 3-4 weeks. Yeah. Well, my friend Kyle, or some of you guys know him as Jay Daxter, the guy that I mostly play with in my videos, he told me about this game. It is an MMORPG game. This one is really good, guys. Like, you can customize your character exactly how you want to customize your character. As you see here, I made my character the Destroyer class, and they have the axe as their weapon, and they got, there's like a whole bunch of different classes. There's different races, and I'm not going to be showing you guys that right now, because I've already made two characters, and I don't have money right now to unlock another slot for another character, but yeah, I made Darius from League of Legends. Like, I couldn't make it exactly like that, but it's close enough, like the hairstyle. That's the only thing that you can't change exactly how you wanted the hair. You have to, like, pick certain different styles they already have for you. But, yeah, I got these clothes are from a certain boss called the Stalker. And what you do is, whenever you defeat the Stalker, you get, like, these turns on this wheel that you can do. And it's like a drop from the wheel. The axe I've gotten from, it's the Hong Moon axe you get by just regularly playing the Destroyer. You, once you get the level up your axe enough, you get to transform it, and you have the, you need to have the Blight axe. I don't know if I just said sword or whatever, but I feel like I just said sword instead of axe on one of those sentences. But, yeah, you need the Blight Axe, and you need, I think it's like, some type of gems or something you need, and upgrade it, and now I have the Awakened Blight Axe, and that's what it looks like. It looks pretty sick. But, yeah, I'm already level 24 on this account. I think the max rank is 45, I'm not 100% sure. And, yeah, so there's Darius, and I made Kat as an assassin, but I'm not going to play her yet. That's going to be on probably a different video. But yeah, Blade and Soul, if you want to go ahead and play the game, I can leave a link in the description for where you can download it. And yeah, let's go ahead and start this. Now, this game just came out pretty recent, so if you're playing like in the evening time, I don't know if they changed it or whatever, but on the servers, like, a lot of servers would be filled up, and you'd, sorry for that burp, but you had to wait in a queue, and, like, one time I had to wait for, like, 1,000 people, and it said, like, 50 minutes or something like that, but I don't know if that's still a thing, but I have the premium membership, which it just automatically lets me into the game, thanks to my friend Kyle. But yeah, waiting. This is a really fun game. I haven't played it in like 3 days though, because I've been playing League of Legends. Now we wait. Alright, that loading screen took a little while, so I just cut the video. But, alright, let's see what I need to do here. I need to zoom out first, I guess. Up close. I need to
thank you for G-Hi's message.
No, I don't want to talk to you. Oh, shit. Oh, no. Memories don't. What these guys say. I don't really go for the storyline. I did in the beginning, but there's like a whole different like storyline to this game, too. But yeah, we're gonna do some of these missions so I can level up. Get a little bit of lag here and there, but there's a lot of stuff loading in. need to defeat border scouts. Where? I don't see. I do not see.
Hold still!
Alright, I actually found what they look like. They're like a dude with a bolt or something. I was looking around and I just couldn't find him, but I just found one. And I have a kill 9 of these guys. That's wonderful. You wanna fight me? Get that. Oh, that's also another mission we have to do. Spin the win for Darius too. That 1,200 crit though. Alright, there's the guys that I need to kill, the border scout guys. Yeah, I was just talking to that guy. He was like, Darius from League? I'm like, yeah. It's like the second time somebody's mentioned that. First time I didn't know how to talk in chat, so kind of sucked. Awesome. No! See, I just hate this sometimes, how people just... do that. I hate how there's limited NPCs that you can fight, and you pretty much have to wait for it. But, yeah, I will see you guys when I'm finished with this mission, and then, to the next one. Alright guys, we're on our next mission. I just had to finish that up. I had to kill, like, 9 of those guys or something. And now we're going to do the next mission, which is find the blue Poggle hiding in the house. So, yeah. This should be pretty easy, because these guys are pretty easy. That's like my main combo right there. Let's just talk to him. Boom. Now we're going to... I don't know if we should just do all these missions and head back for the rewards, or we should just go back now. Because there's a cave that we have to go up there. So I think I'm just going to head back and do the second part to these missions. But before I do that, if you guys are having trouble with, like, going places like in Blade and Soul, I can just tell you guys about some of the stuff. When you get these, they're repair tools. Whenever you're by a campfire and you're, like, as you see here, my axe is kind of low. Well, not really low, but it's been used, like, part of the durability. And whenever you're by a campfire, you can use these repair tools, and they will repair your weapon. Inventory. Alright, whenever you guys get these dragon trade pouches, if you have these in your inventory or whatever, you can click that right there, and it'll expand your inventory by, like, how much is that? 8 slots. But, I think the dragon trade pouches, they get, like, the quantity you need more and more every time you go through a section. These things are called soul shields, and they're actually really good. Like, whenever you get a soul shield, I'd recommend, like, put it on. But, there's, like, sets of them. Like, as you can see here, there's, the one that I have on right now is the Viridian Valor Soul Shield. And, the total of it gives me, the set effect. Like, if you have 3 of them, it'll give you 6 defense. If you have, 5 of them, it'll give you 180 HP. And if you have all 8 of them, it'll give you 61 in crit, and it'll give you defense of 10. Which is that's actually, like, really good. In each different soul shield, they give you, like, a separate buff for that, like, piece. I'm trying to work towards the Blight Soul Shield right now. And what you need to do is, there's a... I'm not 100% sure on all this, but there is a dungeon or something, and I can't remember what the dungeon's name was, but that's, like, where you get, like, all the Blight weapons and everything that's, like, Blight tier. But yeah, that's your inventory, your soul shields, your weapons. Oh yeah, gems. They kind of explain this kind of early, but kind of might not understand it. To get gems, you can actually go down here to gather ingredients. And I think whenever you get like, I think it's like something dust. Hold on. Oh, triangular gem fragments. You get these from taking gems and salvaging it, like that right there. You can salvage stuff. And whenever you get three of those, you can turn that into a box, or like for different. There's different ones. Four for that one, and then five pentagonal for that one. But yeah, there's like really good ones. I'm not gonna go like too in depth in the gems or anything, but yeah, that's how you get gems. And you can also get gems from I can't remember. It's like where all the poggles are. And there's like this big frog guy you can kill, and like he'll drop stuff, and you get gems by doing that too. That's like a, I think that's like around level 18 or something when you'll fight him. But yeah, and then you can equip them to your weapons, and it'll give your weapons like special abilities. As you can see here, this one gives me 35 additional damage when an enemy is stunned or knocked down. That gives me 30 life drain. So every time I get a critical hit, I'll get 30 health back. And this one is stunning enemy for 1.5 seconds, and it can only happen every 30 seconds. These are just accessories that you can find out and just equip to your character. They also give you stuff too. Yeah, and you can also go to the shop if you have things already and you don't want them. You can just sell them, get copper, and then it's kind of like World of Warcraft with the money system. Once you have 100 copper, it'll turn into 1 silver. Whenever you get 100 silver, it'll turn into 1 gold, and so on. But yeah, that's kind of an explanation for the inventory. Now for the gameplay, you got your tab ability. I don't know for the other characters, but yeah, that's my spin to win. But there is the Kung Fu Master, Force Master, Destroyer, Blade Dancer. I can't remember all of them, but there's quite a bit of classes. I'm playing the Destroyer. Your left click is your regular swing ability. It's like a 3 combo type of thing. Your right click, this one gives me all my damage. But yeah, some of my abilities might look different if you guys are playing Destroyer too, because I've upgraded them when you go through like chapter 17 or something like that in the story, and you get to upgrade your abilities. But then your one ability as the Destroyer, like if you're kind of far away from somebody, you press 1, you'll leap to them. And it'll stun everybody in that area that you leap to. Your 2 ability is you run in, you charge at them, and it'll stun that person. And whenever you like stun or knock somebody down, you can actually, with the Destroyer, you can grab them and pick them up and start beating them up and stuff. Your 3 ability, stomp the ground, lava comes up around you, and people take damage over time. And your 4th ability, I really forget which one that is. But, yeah, and then you got your V, I think it's a V, yeah, that's V, and you pull out this huge shield, and you get lifesteal every single time you attack somebody with it. If you're low on health, inventory, or at the bottom, you can hold down Alt, go to whatever, click on it. Dumblings recover health, and healing tonics recover health as well. But, yeah, mostly explained everything. And whenever you level up, there's these surveys that you can take at the bottom, like of how well they, like, ask you questions about how well they did with Blade and Soul, and you just answer them. and you get free stuff. So also there is, I forget what it's called, but it's like this wheel or whatever. Whenever you log in, it should be ready, and you spin that wheel and you can get some good stuff from spinning it. But yeah, let's go ahead and head over here. And I thought I saw somebody over here with I'm confused, because I thought I saw somebody over here with a thing that there it is. So I can complete this quest. 28 copper, 1000 something XP. Now I have to run here and talk to these people. Never mind, I don't have to talk to these people. I just have to do something to help this guy.
Thank you.
Or girl, never mind.
Stay strong, Captain.
And let's see how much I get. While I appeal, I get 28 copper.
You must go to the Tyrian storehouse. Ensure the Stratus agent is safe.
Premium bonus gives me 3 extra copper. But yeah, I'd recommend if you guys, if there's like really long wait times and you really want to play the game, get the premium membership, and you can get in the game pretty much instantly. I also got 2 healing tonics and lots of XP, so, and I think it's also boosted XP when you have the premium membership, so you can level up faster. We're gonna talk to this person. That guy looks kind of weird, but, yeah, let's just head over here. Apparently I have to gather white herbs. There's also, PvP in this game, too. You dare. I hate that so much when people go to the stuff that you're about to run to and they just take it. Somebody pick up their loot. Well, it's fine. Yeah, my right mouse button ability does so much damage. I don't see. Oh, I'm. Yeah, I'll show you the ram ability. I'll run into them, pick them up. Oh, never mind. Just destroy them because I'm the destroyer. And I also went against Kyle. Yeah, I'm gonna put you on blast, Kyle. I 1v1 you and I beat you. You should feel salty. But whenever you like fight people, it evens out your level, so it puts you both at level 45. So it's even. Like, so there's no advantages to having higher tier weapons or anything. Yeah. And you can also play with your friends. Add them to a party or whatever. Do missions together. I don't have Kyle on right now. But in later videos we can play. There's a lot of these I have to get. And I don't know how well this game runs with lower-end computers. I've never tried because it takes a long time to download this game. And I don't want to download it on my other computer because my other computer sucks butt. Where am I supposed to go? Oh, I completed the mission. Alright, I'm just going to head over here. Jump. Fly to the sky. That's really slow. Accept this mission. Hopefully I can level up in this video. Oh yeah, it's this guy. 970. Okay. Let's head up to this dungeon. Let's get a dungeon in this hallway. Something here. That was just a new thing in my inventory. Okay. This dungeon might be kind of difficult. Probably not, but let's spawn out. Oh wait, that's just a daily mission thing. Well, let's just do that anyway. Get free stuff. But yeah, whenever you go in these type of dungeons, in your earlier level, you probably want to play with other people. It's kind of hard to 1v1 a boss at the end of it. But if you have tons of abilities and stuff, like later on, you probably 1v1 them, so. That's what I was doing. There's like this... this one earlier mission where there's like flamethrowers in the caves or whatever, and like I pick up a flamethrower every single time it would break. So, yep. it was kind of easy. And then Kyle came in, and he helped me, even though I didn't ask for help. But yeah, I don't know if I did ask for help. Probably did. But we'll just ignore that, because I'm a boss. Alright, we're almost here. I didn't explain windstriding. Windstriding is, you see these green things on the map? If you click on them, you can pay to teleport to any location with these symbols, and, so you don't have to run everywhere, because there's stamina on here. I don't know. I just feel like there shouldn't be a stamina bar. But we're gonna go in here, and hopefully it's not lag. Yeah, that's kind of scary. Yeah, I know. So there's probably people I'm gonna have to fight in here. I don't know what you're saying, but okay. And we're gonna fight people. Not like people, but NPCs. And like these guys, they think they're good, but I'm just gonna... Sorry, I got a little excited. I hate when I'm in combat and I run really slow. Okay, what am I supposed to do? You wanna fight? You wanna fight me? Pick you up. Slam you on this guy. And then just do my damage. You wanna fight too? So. Oh, I can't pick this guy up. Oh, I could then, but. You wanna fight? What's my exit? Oh. Okay. Yeah, I'd say you can do that. Slam you to the ground. These people really think that they can fight me, especially this guy. Down, doggy. Oh, my core ability is where I sweep them. Oh, you wanna fight? I just literally one-shot these guys. I think it's supposed to be defending these. This won't be an easy fight. Yeah, it's kinda easy so far, I guess. Yeah, it's zombies. We got wolves. Always the dogs. My guy is so slow. Come on, are you dying? said be careful. I was trying to clear my throat, but that also sounded like annoyance in my throat. Oh, not these. Cinematic type of animation skill that will last like 5 seconds. But he's also difficult to play. Unlike the destroyer. Corpse! Just kind of let all these guys just... Yeah, I'm gonna just do that. So, miniature things I'm killing. What is this thing? Does this thing even have health? Why am I defending this if it has no health? I don't even know how long I'm supposed to be in here. How long is this mission? I'm just gonna cut it, guys. Just fought a boss, and I forgot to record it. So I'm feeling pretty salty right now. Yeah. But, we got this. Because, he kind of came out of nowhere, and I just was trying to survive. But yeah, we got some XP. We got a box, a Necros. I don't know. And complete this quest. What is this? Oh wow, instant delivery fee. Another Cinderlands.
Your inventory is full.
That sucks. I'll just get rid of some of this. Oh yeah, the Viridian Valor Stones. That's how you get the Viridian Soul Shield. Everything seems important. I don't think I need that. Alright, I heard scary noises and I was concerned. Hey! Alright guys, well, I'm gonna open up these chests real quick, see what we get here. Healing tonic, that's always good. Locked corrupted weapon chest and sealed dark moon's ring. Let's open up this chest. Sealed corrupted staff. I don't use staffs, so I'm just gonna use that to level up this if I can. But yeah, guys, that's the end of this episode for Blade and Soul. If you guys wanna go ahead and see some more Blade and Soul episodes or check out other videos on my channel, go ahead and subscribe. If you liked the video, like the video. If you didn't like it, dislike, tell me why. And, yeah, see you guys in the next video. Peace.